So this today's what we will cover about for power electronics. I was told that some of you guys are not really too familiar how it works. So I'll be more or less covering from scratch, very basic fundamentals, and over time, of course, I'll grow up higher level course of things. Alright? So mostly because you guys are dealing with IoT, right? I try to gear this presentation towards basic power measurement and efficiency, and at least something enough to keep you guys going in terms of your projects, you know, be it small scale stuff or larger power related, you know, activities. A little bit of myself, I'm quite new to this group, so I came across to this by a friend, so I myself also wanted to know about, share this knowledge, and I basically work as a product engineer, so more or less my hardware, I'll be doing a lot of hardware related activities. And that's where my software skills also lack. So it's all good to learn from each other. Alright? So a little bit about my company is basically doing all magnetic products, passive components, inductors, transformers. So that's what we usually do for core products. And I myself, my activity is to do a bit of the customer application support and product development, like new materials, ferrite new materials, core makers, and all these things. So at the end of the day, you know, if we talk about new materials, these are the key things that actually makes your passive components behave better and better in terms of circuitry performance. Alright? So basically, these are the kind of questions I've been asked so far, you know, in terms of my job scope, my people, and my family as well. You know, can I hook up 5 server computers? You know, can I have 6 hand dryers going at the same time? All these kind of rhetorical questions, you know, like what is single phase versus 3 phase? What's the difference? And why are there so many voltage values? What can I do to cater to all? Alright? So before we understand how to install 5 server desktop into a room, you must understand first how grids are being distributed. Alright? So this is a very simple topology of how power is being supplied from a power plant to your home, which is a 240 volt. Okay? And what kind of power are we talking about? Each cable is capable of carrying up to 1000 mA of current. Okay, that's the scale of things we are talking about in terms of power grids. Alright, so this is just for your information. And here we are, is more or less where you guys, this is where you guys are dealing with 240 volts. Okay, I'm dealing with this 33 kilovolts kind of a power line in my company. So yeah, this is just for information. Okay, fundamentals of AC source, very complex in nature. You guys will be dealing with this kind of mathematical calculations if you guys are doing harmonics, RF signals for all your projects. Okay, so this is just a brief look of what you're dealing with. Polar form, rectangular form, etc. Alright? So what is a 3-phase AC source? Alright? Now for a 3-phase, right, it means to say for the same conductor, their current, their three signals pump to the same conductor in different phases. So you can see the very nice sine wave. Alright? Now, what's the beauty of this 3-phase, right? When you actually look at this portion here. You see the rectifier, and you rectify this voltage. Okay? It's all added up together from this, so the voltage will increase a bit. So there's a very good overview in terms of the period for 3-phase versus a single phase when you rectify the voltage. And you can see the output, what do you get? A better DC line compared to this. I mean, this is not. In reality, you will not be so straight, just a little bit, little bit ripple. So this is the main big difference between 3-phase versus single phase. Alright? So the question is, do I need 3-phase for my stuff? For low-end projects, you don't really need 3-phase, single phase is good enough. But for me, when I operate factory machines, like inductor winding machines, transformer winding machines, 3-phase is very efficient, it's cost efficient overall in terms of power saving. Okay, that's the difference. So DC source is very simple, I'm not going to explain much. This is one straight line. Okay? You just need to know the Ohm's law and your Joule's law. Joule's law is basically to calculate power loss, I square R. Alright? This is the most of the things I deal with on a day-to-day basis for AC to DC conversion. So this is the most simplified version I can show you for you to understand. Alright? From AC wave, you go through a bridge rectifier to a full wave rectifier, and then you put a capacitor across to get this ripple, nice DC line. This one to here. Alright? So at this point, for those who are dealing, who are learning this power electronic from scratch, this is the fundamentals. All this is just a basic fundamental. Alright? You only need to take note of the transformer voltage and what you want. This can be 12 volt, 9 volt, 5 volt, up to you of what kind of transformer you buy. Okay, for those of you who are more experienced with AC to DC conversion, when you buy your own transformer for your own IoT application or maybe other stuff, these are the kind of pros and cons advantage you need to know what kind of model you want. Okay? There's a the typical one is the regulated linear circuitry. Basically, just use a voltage regulator to smoothen the DC line. But of course, it's quite economical. Nowadays, everybody is using switch mode power supply because of this magical ability to tune to what frequency you want. So that's where high frequency transformers comes in. Alright, so this switch mode power supply topology is quite complex. I will not cover for today's talk. Slowly we'll see how it goes. Interestingly, when I went to India, this is the kind of transformer they use. Have you ever wondered why, if I went to India, there's always a short power trip every now and then? Okay, it's just that the way they transmit is not very efficient for this. In some sense, they need to actually use this one of this topology to regulate, to make sure the power won't trip so much. So this is just more or less for you to understand what kind of transformer you guys are looking for. So this is just a better elaboration of what is three-phase versus a single-phase that you guys use. You know, you can see the big dip. Oops. Yeah, sorry about that. Okay, thanks. So you can see the oh. Sorry, I'm not a Mac user.
It's fine. I just have
Alright. Yeah, so you can see the ripple current. The ripple voltage is more less, it's a lesser ripple compared to the big gap. Here it's smaller. So that's the idea, that's the more like the generalized simplest way I can explain three-phase in terms of what's the advantages are. Okay, but do know that three-phase is actually quite expensive to implement. Okay, we're talking about like huge, we're talking about like costing for materials to build it. Okay. So this is a very, very simple guide, what is AC versus DC? Why do we use AC to transmit power line? Why don't we use DC to transmit, you know? This is a very simple overall, you know, gist of it. I mean, look at it this way. If I want to actually do a step down of voltages, right? Do I want to go through all this or just build a transformer? Okay. All these things require circuitry analysis. This is just more like a better base. This base is based on the one winding and one parallel core and wire wind to step down. So in some sense, right, this term is what I call a cheaper option. Okay, a cheaper option. Okay. But however, do note that actually you can transmit power using DC as well, okay? This is done from the UK. Okay? You can actually transmit power using DC, but and there are advantages at number one. You don't have any phase or harmonic issues, because it's just a straight line. The second thing is no skin effect. Skin effect is basically mean to say that your current do not flow through the entire copper. You only flow through the surface of the copper. That is skin effect. And that only happens when there's a wave, there's an electromagnetic wave going through the copper. DC, there's no wave, it's just one straight line. So you don't have that physics effect. For those of you interested, you can check out this high voltage diagram and keep it just get a better idea what it's about. Okay, power rating. So let's go to actually what can you make out of it in terms of what you use in terms of your projects. Okay, now first and foremost, very simple. Okay, when you have current flowing through your element, be it a resistor, capacitor, or your inductor, there will always be heat. Forever, there will always be heat. Alright? And this heat is what actually destroys your component eventually if you don't keep it in check. Okay? So basically, the idea behind this concept of power being supplied into your project, the idea is this, okay? Regardless of whether you use three-phase, single-phase, or DC to transmit your power, the power being supplied to your component is only limited to the current capacity of your source. Okay, that means if your transformer can only handle up to 5 ampere, you'll always be limited to that power range. Okay, any more, you'll damage your power supply. Okay, like for example, this one example of transformer I handled before. I've seen it burn many times because one of my few customers, they just overload it. And they draw more than they should. Okay, and naturally, it can cause quite a fire. So be careful when you play with your projects. Okay, like I said, everything has a current rating or current limit. Okay, even for resistor, there's a power rating at 70 degrees, at 1 watt. Even for capacitor, there's also a current limit you can use. Any more, you go hot and just burn off. Okay, everything, inductor, transformers also. Transformers also, the wire can only handle up to 155 degrees. My ferrite core can handle to 300 degrees. So you're only as strong as your biggest link, your wires. So how do I actually implement this knowledge into my home usage? Okay, now this is the typical power map I took for my home, for my room. Okay, you can see my bedroom number 2, and you can see the power socket P4. Okay, when I check P4 in my power supply, I only have up to 13 ampere worth of current to be used in my room. Any more, the power will trip. Okay, so how do I use this knowledge to calculate how much power am I going to use for my projects? Okay, very simple. We just follow this very simple power equation, P over VI, or if you're using a transformer, power equals to VA. It's literally the same thing. So let's say, for example, I use my PC has this PSU, power supply unit, okay? It has a very nice 5 ampere with 240 volts, okay? And my computer guarantees an 87 efficiency. So more or less, I'm drawing 4 ampere for my computer rating. Okay? And those of you who, ladies who love to use hair dryer is a very heavy power consumption device. It's only 4.5 ampere. So if I on these two at the same time, you're more or less really drawing about current about 8.5 ampere from your power supply for your room. So going back to the question, do you think you on 5 server computers now? It that depends on the power limit, right? Depends on why. So all these things, the moral of the story is, you want to do this, fine, no problem, but please calculate first. You want to on all these things, all the objects. If you want on everything at the same time, it's okay. So make sure you calculate. Okay? And the rule of the thumb is this, never always assume that you're using the most power. This is the rule of thumb. So next time, those of you who want to experiment with wireless charging, high power wireless charging, came up to 3 ampere, 4 ampere, this is something to take note. So I'll give you a very good example of what I did. Okay, this is one example I did for my wireless charging projects in my company. So let's say before we go through, let's talk about LOPO. What is LOPO? You hear this all the time, but what is it really about? Okay, basically it's the device that draws power from the power supply. It draws, okay, mainly your projects. Okay, it's usually measured in resistive or Z ohms. Z ohms for impedance. Okay, that's a more higher level calculation. So a very simple module-based transmitter and receiver. Just for you, this is my transmitter. This is my receiver. Now this module is capable of delivering up to 100 watt plus. Okay, I haven't really go and test it to the limit yet. So let's see how I do it. So this is a very simple, simplified schematic. Okay, so basically I input 24 volts inside. Okay, and I mentioned my load will be my electronic load, a power tool, a battery, anything you want. Because it's just DC. Okay, so your load, your R load will depend on what device you're being used. Okay, every single PCB board has a different load. You have to find out what the load is first. Okay, the safest way to do this kind of experiment is always use an electronic load. Okay, but an electronic load costs a fair bit, like $1,000 plus or whatever. Okay, so this is my efficiency test I did for my wireless powers module board. Okay. So basically how I hook it up is this. I measure my current and my volt across my load. Okay. And this is my results. Okay, so basically my input will always be the same 24 volt. My output also will be the same voltage, 24 volts. Okay. And actually you realize that, you know, the power input and the power output, 190 watts, gives me about maybe 88% efficiency. Alright? So this is a very simplified version you guys can use to measure for your own power applications in terms of whatever modules you're using. Okay? You just need to know how much voltage and current you are getting input, how much voltage and current is being supplied, and you need to know how much voltage and current you draw. Then you roughly know what's the efficiency already. Okay, a very layman term for this. So yeah. So it's good to say that wireless power transfer can hit up to 90% in future. Okay? And that's only for 100 watt board. So more or less is a very basic example for you guys. With that, I have nothing else really. You know, that's all I have to say for this today's talk. Is there any questions you want to ask so far?